Okay, we are done with all the formulas in this chapter. Now let's put all of the above together. Don't worry, it sounds a lot scarier than, you know, it's going to be a lot easier than it sounds. That's what I'm trying to say. So let's do an international capital budgeting example. It means nothing but calculating the net present value for an international company that's evaluating its overseas investment opportunity. As always, we're going to be calculating the project's net present value. If the net present value we find is above $0, we're going to recommend to accept this investment opportunity. Otherwise, if the net present value is below $0, we would recommend to reject this investment opportunity. There are two different ways we could solve an NPV problem like that. Two approaches to overseas project valuation: the so-called home currency approach and the so-called foreign currency approach. The home currency approach first estimates the cash flows for year 0, 1, 2, and so on in the foreign currency. And then the idea is we want to convert those foreign currency cash flows into the home currency, into the dollars, right? As quickly as we can. So we would, to do that, we would need to know which exchange rate to use for each year's cash flow. So we estimate future exchange rates. Which formula from this chapter can we use for that? We can use the uncovered interest rate parity formula. So we're going to review it in our next example. Once we have the exchange rate for year 1, year 2 in the future, year 3 in the future, and so on, we can then convert our foreign currency cash flows into the domestic currency cash flows, into the dollars. That's step number 3. And then in the last step, we just discount the dollar cash flows using the domestic required return to find the net present value in dollars. The foreign currency approach has everything kind of backwards, pretty much. We basically keep everything in the foreign currency until the very end. So we estimate our cash flows in the foreign currency. This is, you know, the same step one across the two approaches. Then we discount them. So we're essentially you know, finding the NPV in the foreign currency rather than in dollars. What do we use for the discount rate for that NPV calculations? We use the international Fisher effect to convert the domestic required return to foreign required return. And then we do the discounting to find the NPV, which will be the NPV denominated in the foreign currency rather than in dollars. So it's like we are finding the NPV in the foreign currency, and only in the last step we convert the foreign currency NPV into dollars using today's spot exchange rate. So it's like in the home currency approach, the first thing we want to do is convert all cash flows for the project into dollars. With the foreign currency approach, we want to convert everything into dollars last, and we are calculating the NPV in the foreign currency as kind of big step one. Okay, so it turns out that it actually doesn't matter which of the two approaches you decide to use to find the net present value for your overseas project, because both will give you the same exact net present value. Let's look at the following example. A US cell phone company is considering selling its cell phones in Germany. The initial cost of the cell phone project in Germany would be 10 million euros. Notice how it's denominated in euros rather than in dollars. And that's kind of the whole point of this overseas project valuation. Everything starts with a foreign currency. expected revenues from this project. It's actually more like profits. That would be a more correct word to use. After-tax profits. We learned that from in chapter 10 in this class. So expected after-tax profits are 2 million euros in 1 year, 3 million euros in 2 years, 5 million euros in 3 years, and 10 million euros in 4 years. The risk-free rate in the USA is 5%, and it's 8% in Germany. The current spot exchange rate is 0.67 euros per dollar, which is the same thing as $1.50 per 1 euro. The required rate of return on similar investments in the USA is 10%. Calculate the net present value of this cell phone project in Germany. Okay, let's start with the home currency approach first. Step 1 says estimate cash flows in foreign currency. We already have them. They're given. Year 0 cash flow is negative 10 million euros. Year 1, 2 million euros. Year 2, 3 million euros. Year 3, 5 million euros. And year 4, 10 million euros. They're given, so we don't need to calculate anything for step 1. Step 2. The goal is to convert all the future cash flows back into dollars. So for that, we need to know what exchange rate we will use for each year. So in step 2, we estimate future exchange rate for each year using the uncovered interest rate parity formula. The formula says the expected exchange rate for any year in the future equals today's spot exchange rate multiplied by, open parentheses, 1 plus the difference between the foreign risk-free rate and the US risk-free rate, close parentheses, raised to the power t, t indicating the number of years in the future for which we are trying to estimate the spot exchange rate. So next year's expected exchange rate equals today's spot rate, which is 0.67 euros per dollar, multiplied by, open parentheses, 1 plus foreign country's risk-free rate, which is Germany's 8% rate, or 0.08 in decimals, minus the US risk-free rate, or 0.5%, or in decimals, 0.05. We don't use any power, although we could put 1 at the end of the, closing bracket. The answer is 0.69 euros per $1. So that's the expected exchange rate in 1 year. The only thing that we change in the calculations of the expected exchange rates for years 2, 3, and 4 is the power at the end of the parentheses. Powers 2, 3, and 4. And the answers we get are 0.71 euros per dollar, 0.73 euros per dollar, 0.75 euros per $1. The numbers will be kind of continuously increasing, right? And by the way, this means that the dollar is expected to get stronger because each dollar can give us more and more and more euros. But that's not the question that we are answering. So let's move on. Now that we have the exchange rates estimated for each future year of this 4-year project in Germany, we can then proceed to step number 3. Convert future cash flows from euro into dollars. So we had our cash flows in euros. We convert them into dollars using the proper exchange rate for that year. So for example, to convert the initial investment 10 million euros into dollars, we take 10 million euros and divide by 0.67 euros per dollar, which was given as today's exchange rate or the current spot exchange rate. This gives us negative $15 million. The same way we convert next year's cash flow from euros into dollars using the exchange rate we found in step number 2 for, as the estimated exchange rate for that time. So we take 2 million euros divided by 0.69 euros per dollar from the previous step, which gives 2.9 million dollars. And then the same way, we divide 3 million euros from year 2, 5 million euros from year 3, and 10 million euros from year 4 by their own exchange rates that we estimated in the previous step for years 2, 3, and 4 to give us the estimated project's cash flows for these years expressed in dollars. So the second year's cash flow in dollars is $4.2 million. The third year's cash flow in dollars is $6.9 million. And the fourth, the final year's cash flow is $13.3 million. Okay, we're done with step three. What's now left is combining all these cash flows from this project into one sort of summarizing dollar amount, which is the net present value, the profitability of this four-year project. So step two, discount the dollar cash flows using the domestic, the US required return. The required return on similar investments in the USA is 10%. It's given to us. So we take minus $15 million from year zero, and we add all future dollar cash flows discounted back to year zero using the 10% given discount rate. So for example, from year one, we add $2.9 million divided by 1 plus 0.1. From year two, we have $4.2 million cash flow divided by 1 plus 0.1 squared. And then the third year's discounted dollar cash flow uses the third power in the denominator, and the last year's discounted cash flow uses the fourth power in the denominator. Of course, this is something you can do in just one step in the financial calculator. Either way, you get $5.41 million. And your conclusion for this project would be to accept it because it's worth it. Let's do it in the financial calculator. Let me bring it up. Let me clear everything. Second, plus, minus, enter. Off and back on. So cash flow keys in the financial calculator start with pressing the cash flow, the CF button. What's cash flow in year zero? It's minus $15 million. So let's, you know, drop the six zeros for the millions and do it in millions, right? So 15, negative, enter. Now it's saved. I press the down arrow key. The display shows cash flow of 1. What's cash flow number 1 in the future? That's 2.9 million. I put 2.9. I save it by pressing enter. I press the down arrow key. But before I enter my second year's cash flow, the display wants me to give the information on the frequency of the first year's cash flow, F01. The default is 1, and we're going to keep it at the default value of 1, because we would only need to change it to something else, like 2, for example. If we had 2.9 million repeating again, consecutively, two consecutive years, back to back. But that's not the case in our entire problem. So all the frequencies for each of our future cash flow will actually be left at the default value of 1. So I can press enter and then the down arrow key again, or I could just press the down arrow key without pressing the enter. It would, you know, not make any difference. Cash flow number 2 in the future, 4.2. Enter, down, and down arrow key again. Cash flow number 3 in the future, 6.9. Enter, down, down. And the fourth future cash flow, 13.3. Enter, down, down. That's it. There is no more cash flow number 5. Now I just need to compute the net present value based on all these cash flows I have just entered, using 10% for the discount rate. 10% is given. So I press the NPV button. I is the interest rate that I need to enter. So I put 10, enter, down, compute. 5.38. So I think the reason I'm a little bit off from what I said earlier, which was 5.41 million, is because there must be some rounding error that happened when we were actually finding all these dollar cash flows, because we were really rounding them too much. They're like, remember, in millions of dollars. So there are like six more digits after the million value, right? So they're probably already rounded in the previous steps, and that's why I got a slightly different number. But 5.41 million that I had explained earlier is more accurate because it's actually based on unrounded values. Okay, so 5.41 million if you don't round any of your intermediate steps, and that implies that the project is worth it.